ting and the ting, yes, the jingles and the tinsel and the gaiety and the booze. And the booze wipes out some of the gaiety too sometimes, because you're talking about something that is just a part of the holidays and something that people have a very difficult time handling. April Schaffroth is going to help us. She's a DUI expert representing AZDUIProcess.
It's a free service that helps guide someone once they've been convicted of DUI step by step to regaining their license. There's nothing like this in Arizona, and it takes all the resources you need when you're getting your license back in one step. It's free. It comes from the counseling, traffic Bible school, the interlock system, insurance, and we really are a concierge to kind of help guide you through that process.
Okay, I'm going to tell you something publicly now that I haven't said to anybody publicly. Somebody very close to me was convicted of extreme DUI a few months ago, wound up in Tent City. Said it's an experience that is never going to happen in that person's life again.
Right, my goodness.
But it is one of those things that happens to all too many people. Now, first of all, myth. Let's dispel this. Food and water in advance. How much does it help?
Very good question. You're just going to be a hydrated drunk or a full drunk. It's not so much the amount of alcohol or food you have or the water you have. It takes about an hour. Your liver to process an alcoholic drink, so it does not help. And it a lot of times people say, "Oh, I'm a big person," or "I'm a tall person," or "You know, I've had some appetizers." It's all the same. Alcohol is alcohol. If it's a 12-ounce beer or an ounce and a half shot of whiskey or a glass of wine, it's all the same.
But the nutrition is there certainly prior to the green bologna,
right?
Okay. Another area of conversation that has been a discussion point for as long as I suppose there's been beer and liquor and wine, and that is coffee makes it all better.
Good question. No, it makes you jittery and kind of caffeinated for a little bit. They say coffee wakes me up and sobers me for the drive. That's not the case. You're going to be jittery. You will not be extra alert. That first alcoholic drink slows your motor skills and dims your vision, so you can have a pot of coffee and it doesn't affect you. Splashing cold water in your face, rolling your window down, it just makes you awake and clean, and the alcohol is still in your system, and it takes that full hour per drink.
Our friend Alice Cooper has said this on so many different occasions, so he doesn't mind my saying it too. His alcohol problem was beer, and people just simply, for some reason or other, don't think that beer is as much a problem as another beverage.
Isn't that the case? They say, "Oh, I have the natural ice or the ones that don't affect it." And the alcohol from a 12-ounce beer is the exact same as a 5-ounce glass of wine, so it does not matter. But that misconception is there. So, you know, when you go out to an event or going out to a party, for example, eat, because that definitely helps. Drink water pre to drinking, because the more you have in your system, it takes longer for the alcohol to absorb. The alcohol will still get there, but it just gives you a little bit of a buffer, if you will, to start the evening.
You know, I've actually had somebody at a party say to me, "No, don't worry, Pat. I'm not going to drive fast when I drive home. I'm going to just really take it easy on the highway, and therefore nobody's going to be in trouble."
Well, that is a very common misconception. So they say, "Well, if I drink, I'm going to slow down." That can be just as dangerous. Something that's interesting is that 40% of all the crashes happen during the entire holiday season. So the highway-related alcoholic deaths during Christmas time is 41%. It increases to 58% during New Year's for that highway-related deaths for alcohol. So people say, "I'm going to slow down and drive." It affects everyone in such a negative way, and that's when you get convicted of DUI, then we come to help. But how do we prevent that ahead of time? So when you're hosting a party, you know, everyone says you have to have drinks to have a good time, but really, you know, have a fun signature, like I call mocktails. So it's the non-alcoholic drinks, but make it fun for those people as well.
Or just have somebody else drive.
Yes, so that's the issue is now is we have the best ride shares out there. AZDUIProcess is partnered with Uber. We have our own DUI Uber code. Yeah, so AZDUIProcess.com is the Uber code. You have friends and designate drive. The average DUI costs $10,000 for your first offense. So people say, "Oh, it's too expensive to get a cab," or "It's too expensive for Uber." Drop in a bucket when it comes to a $10,000 DUI.
Yeah, and you also have, in addition to your car,
goodness, you bet. So it's unfortunate. So the minimum you have to have is called an interlock. I work with a company called the Toxilock, and they are great. But once you get convicted, you have to have this in for a minimum of 6 months.
Right, you blow into that?
This, you go, hook it into your car, and you have to blow into it. Every time you start your car, it won't do it until you do. And if you have any sort of alcohol in your system, it gives an alert. And these, for example, can cost anywhere between $60 to $120 a month. So it is a big deal. And people say, well, maybe I just won't drive. You know, I'll just work around it. There's, in Arizona, we are a zero-tolerance state, as you've probably heard. And we are wonderful, but spicy and very tough in regulations. So you can't get out of it.
But
so
tell everybody right now how to get in touch with you.
KAZDUIProcess.com. And we, it's a free service, and we walk you through everything step by step.
Yeah, as long as you're being walked through a process, you might as well be able to walk to begin with, huh? Mm-hmm. Wouldn't be a bad idea. Please, have a happy, safe, and sober